Controla a bola, controla a bola.
Thank you.
Isso! Isso aí! Isso! Vai embora! Vai embora!
Juiz! Ah, juiz! Ah, juiz! Ah, juiz! novo tá com raiva, hein?
Thank you.
ruim, gente! Esse 17 é ruim demais, meu Deus do céu! Thank you.
Thank you.
teve que jogar fora pra ver. Troco 9! Olha lá, tirou 7, gente. Troco 9, técnico!
Thank you. Welcome everybody for second half action here at Britland Park. The score at the half is Bristol Community College. The Bayhawks are up 4-0 against Monroe College out of the Bronx, New York. So we're gonna zero in here for a second half action as we get this one underway. So first half goals. We got goals by Gerlimre Antunes, Matthew Mata, Bradley Texera, and also Bradley Texera. So that's the score, 4-0 at the half. We're getting ready for second half action here at Britland Park. Beautiful day. Beautiful day for soccer. Women's team played the Monroe College women's team last week in their season opener, which they did win. Women's team off to a great start this season. 2-1 on the young season. Women's team coached by Jason Tassinari. And the women's Bristol Community College Bayhawks team was very successful yesterday in a win against Quinn Sigamon College right here at Britland Park. Got a whistle. So the Monroe Express, so to speak, coming here today. Long drive. They come in 0-1. They come in 0-1 on the young season. All right, I think we're gonna have a trip over here. Referee raises his flag. Kicking a save. Bristol Community College, coached by Peter Nunes and Dave Pacheco. Peter Nunes, the head coach, just a couple seasons ago led his Bristol Community College Bayhawks team to the Nationals. So he knows what it takes. Knows what it takes to get his team in gear. Bristol Community College, they don't have to attack right now. They have a 4-0 lead. I mean, they can basically keep away for the rest of this thing. Second half action just getting underway here. If you're just joining us here on FR Media, FRC Media, Bristol Community College with a 4-0 lead. Bristol just, no sense of urgency needed. That ball going down the left sideline. Looks like it's gonna go out of bounds. Oh. Again, I'm David Cardoza here on the call. Throw in. Bristol will kick it around midfield. Monroe in blue. That ball kicked down the right side and back to the Bristol goalkeeper. Nice nifty kick back out. Here and a Monroe kick coming up. Oh, nice block there. So we're about 7 minutes into this one in the second half. We get a player down. Looks to be okay. Okay, Malik Gallimore. I think he's the one about to boot this one. Bristol gonna try to make a little wall right here. Protect their goalkeeper. Malik, gonna kick that one way out. It's good. Going. Good. Comes the Monroe Express. Monroe just hasn't been able to get anything going offensively. No continuity in offense. As that ball sails way over.
Cable cross left, eh? Cable cross go left, eh? From bola! Bola pra frente! Bola, meu filho! Vamos acompanhar a bola aí, ó! É hora de gol!
I don't think you're going to see much offense here in the second half. Bristol's sitting on a nice cushy 4-0 lead that they got really early in the first half. All right, a save right there by the Bristol goalie. Ball kicked back up past midfield. There he is.
That
looks like it's going to be. Might be looking at a corner kick here. Nope, it's going to be a toss in. Bronx tossed it in. Bristol been immense on defense. Defense has been very good today, to say the least. Beautiful day at Britland Park by the pond. Here in Fall River, a home game for the Bayhawks.
Come on, it's still the game.
Ball around midfield. Monroe trying to get on the scoreboard. Running out of time. Got about 33 minutes left to play here in the second half. We've got a kick coming up from midfield by Monroe College. Nice header there. Again. Bristol defense draped all over. Draped all over Big Blue over there. Almost a nice give and go there. That ball's out of bounds. It's going to be out of bounds on Monroe College. And Bristol will get a toss in on their own end. Across the box. Scoring attempt. The save. It's going to be a save there. That scoring attempt was by Elmer Barrientos. That was a nice save, though, by the Monroe goaltender. Today, ladies and gentlemen, it's September 11th, so we want to commemorate this day and we want to remember all those who lost their lives and the tragic events of 18 years ago. Hard to believe it's 18 years ago, September 11th. So we want to just remember all those who fell on the day and all the heroes, Daddy, from that day. That tragic day in American history.
I want one, whatever it is.
So September 11th today, never forget. Bristol really just playing keep away here in the second half. As they get the ball coming out of their own end. Oh, here we go. It's a foot race. And it's going to be kicked out of bounds. And I think over the fence. Looks like Bristol's gonna have a corner kick.
Hey, Jimmy!
So Peyton Lee is gonna boot this out of his own corner. I mean, out of the corner in Monroe territory over here. See if we can get a good head action. Best thing you can do is prop one up nice and high in this situation. See if you can get a good header. Well, that ball's kind of low. You kick those corner kicks. You want to get a nice ball with some elevation there. Hopefully someone can go up and get a nice header in. Soccer version of the alley-oop. I'll have another attempt at it. And we have a whistle. Not sure what the whistle's about, but we'll have our third shot at a corner kick over here. Okay. That ball's up there. Can we get a header?
Come on, guys!
Wait.
Ooh. Number 12, that was David Elves.
Pressure, Mike.
kind of wide right there on the net. Lovely day for soccer, huh? So now we'll get a goalie kick. Coming this way, going Monroe's way. About less than 30 minutes to go on this one. There's a boot. Barely makes it to midfield. Bristol gonna have a shot at this one. And that ball is. Just lops one out to his right. Left, I'm sorry. Monroe's, they need to show some sense of urgency.
Come on, you guys, move!
I know the Bristol defense has really been, they haven't allowed many shots on goal. Monroe's offense has been inept. Really haven't been able to get anything going towards Bristol net. And coming up with it. Down the left side. Ooh, got the goalie down on the ground. Nice attempt there, and then the player hurt down there. Ooh, and the goalie will come out of his box to come up and get that one. Get a trip there. And that's going to be a kick. Going to have a good kick here. Going to have a good scoring attempt here at point blank range. Play there. The kick. Oh. Good thought there. Peyton Lee, and I think he's down. I mean, he really tried to boot that one. He went wide, wide of the net. Now he looks like he's down on the ground. And the trainer will come out. And during this injury timeout, we'll take a timeout here. The Bristol Community College Bayhawks lead. The Monroe College Express out of the Bronx, 4-0 here at Britland Park. Right back. All right, welcome back everybody to Britland Park. I'm David Cardoza. Nice sunshiny day here on September 11th. That was Peyton Lee being carried up the field there. You know, Monroe College is a boot. And here come the Bayhawks. Ooh, he had a open path to the net there. And then he lost his footing. Gill kicks it up to number 7, Try to. Monroe now in possession. That is a nice header. Gill kicks that one on goal. The goalie throws it out. Today I'm doing the commentary as well as following these balls around. The balls are nowhere to be found. Today I'm double dipping. Bayhawks playing a nice game of keep away, keeping it away from Monroe. Ooh, goodness, he almost got smashed. That ball sails out of bounds. So we have 22 minutes and 49 seconds to play. We have another semi-casualty here on the field. No, we don't. That ball is in the stands. A lot of balls, more balls still out of bounds than there are goals. And number four will safely get it back to his goalie. There's a boot by number four. Ball's gonna. Thank you. There goes another ball. Number 12, Devin Alves. We'll throw this one in. Who's he gonna throw it to? Oh, had a shot at it.
Good one.
That was a great boot by Bradley Teixeira to get that ball right in the crease. The header was wide, but they had a shot. Bradley Teixeira has a goal here today. So does it Matthew Malta. Bradley Teixeira was assisted by Guilherme Antunes. Matthew Malta was assisted by, my bad. Again, Matthew Marta was assisted on his goal by Saladin Hamas. And also Gil Antunes, he had a goal as well. Four goals on the day.
Chuta, Caio! Isso, Caio!
It's a great day. Not a conference game. Bristol Community College plays in Region 21, the New England region. Monroe plays in Region 15. Both teams coming here 0-1. Bristol looking for their first victory, and they're about to get it. Okay. This game is in the bag. It's Halloween come early. Look at these orange and black uniforms by the refs. It looks like pumpkins. Rally takes Sarah. He's fast. He has a chance. Tries to get over the goal. He gets it. He scores. Goal. Rally takes Sarah with his second goal on the day. Holy cow! And that is all she wrote. You can put it on the board, yes. Five goals on the day by the Bayhawks. It will send Monroe back on their merry way, back to New York, the city that never sleeps. And that's my first goal. Call on the air. Pretty fancy. Probably Texier very fast. And that goalie outran everybody for Monroe. It was basically a race to the ball. And he did not score. Now it was on his second attempt. Stood the course. Get a second goal of the day. I know Coach Peter Nunes, that he must be pleased with his team's performance here on a lovely day. One of the loveliest days of the year.
Yeah, I was the one that put it on.
Monroe with a kick in their own end. It's a nice ball. Nice header there. And there's the man, Bradley Teixeira, number seven. Lucky seven. Stay tuned for more Bristol Community College athletics here in the future. Bristol women's soccer. Bristol men's soccer. And stay tuned for this November as Bristol Community College men and women's basketball teams will be in action. A lot of sports here on FRC Media. Your Bayhawks Broadcasting Network. Also stay tuned for the Bristol Community College Athletics Show. We'll be previewing all the fall teams. Those details will be announced here in the coming weeks. Player and coach interviews, highlights, and a lot more will be coming on the Bristol Community College Athletics Show, hosted by myself, my humble self, David Cardoza. I'll be here with, like I said, I'll be here with you.
Olha pra bola! Olha pra bola!
Look up, guys!
Monroe, gonna get a kick to midfield, headed by Guillermo. Monroe not showing any sense of urgency. They look tired, they look worn out. That ball. Ooh. That was a nice kick. Nice attempt there by number 18. That's KO de Araujo. Stuff getting a little intense on the Monroe side. Stuff getting a little chippy. No, calm down, boys. The game's almost over. Don't fight, boys. All right. Bristol Community College, all they really need to do. Oh, that's a nice pass there. Couldn't connect there. I thought that was a beautiful pass by number 5, Brandon Souza. Tried to hit number 12 there, Devin Elves, in stride. Just couldn't connect. And Monroe, another goal kick. Monroe needs to get something going forward. Go forward, not backwards. What are you doing? And that's going to go back to a Bristol goalie, number 1. Pitching to shut out Wyatt Earp. He's a gunslinger. No, it's Wyatt Pinto, I'm sorry. Devin Alves. Kick it back towards Guilherme Antunes. Ball around midfield. Hey, yours truly just getting warmed up. Bayhawks have possession, stolen away. But getting it right back of the son of a guns. Well, not too much going on here. There's exercise and futility. Ball hemming around, ball bouncing around midfield. Monroe hasn't been able to do anything with that ball today. Nice header there by Elves. Out to midfield. Gil. The man they call Gil has it in the open field. Surrounded by 2 Monroe defenders. Couldn't come away with nothing. You gotta love the aggressiveness, the immenseness of Bristol Community College today. I mean, they've been all over the Monroe Express like a cheap suit on Broadway. He just has so many Bayhawk defenders around him, he can't do anything. This game today, well played. Here's the man of the hour, Bradley Teixeira, back to 17. That kick goes right into the hands of the Bayhawks. Or to the feet. Never to the hands, but to the feet. El swatted at that ball. Made it look effortless. I'm sorry, that was number 18. I'm sorry, KO de Araujo. Got that ball on goal. Not enough stroke on it, though. Bristol Community College. They are looking to be victorious, which they already are. Blue with the ball. That's the best ball all day for the Monroe Express. But again, the Bayhawks defenders doing what they do best, defend. We have less than 10 minutes to play here at the old park, Britland Park. Minutes and 40 seconds to play here in this contest. It's been no contest, really. It's been all Bayhawks. Bayhawks have showed their skill. That ball is going to go. That ball is out of bounds, I believe. Not quite a corner kick, but towards the corner in their own, in the Monroe end. Bayhawks will have a toss in here from out of bounds. It's a header there. Monroe kicks it out. Now the ball's around midfield. Like I said, Bristol, I mean, they can play keep away. Got daylight. Nice little nifty move there. And then out of bounds. Past the goal. It'll be a goal kick. Coming out of the Monroe end. So we're going to get a boot here. By the goalie as time winds down. Here in the river. Rolling, rolling, rolling on the river. Ooh. Bristol plays physical. Monroe taking it out of their own corner. Trying to center it. Ooh, nice block there. And that ball's going to go out of bounds, but it will stay in the possession of Monroe. Tossing it in here is Kamar Galloway. Oh, intercepted. Oh. We'll stay here in the Bristol end. There's a kick. And it's going to sail past the goalie. And Bristol will kick out of their own end. For setting up a goal kick out of their own end. Will lose that one out of bounds. Oh, nice. Nice heads up play there. Bayhawks, they're still looking to attack right now. It's been all Bayhawks here today. all over but the shouting. Monroe just really hasn't had any legit scoring opportunities. Really just the infighting and the constant complaining on the Monroe side. They've just been a team that has been just disoriented and just out of it and just kind of disarray. Their communication's been torrid and terrible. Awful. Constantly pointing the finger. The big Bristol obviously has been more on the same page. And it shows. Bristol can slowly kick the ball upfield in their own. They have a safe 5-0 lead with 4.5 to play here at Britland. And we got some daylight here in the open field, trying to get it up to Gill. And we have a whistle. And let's see what the call on the field is. Regardless of what it is, Monroe will kick it and be in possession. Now the Bayhawks have it. Coming down their left side. The ball kicked out of bounds. I believe it's off Monroe. Bayhawks will toss it in. There's a kick into the crease and then kicked out by a Monroe defender. It's been all white. Hear the fans saying, come on, white. It's been all white. Bristol in the white jerseys. Loose ball, trying to get it, going to turn around, and he goes! And that is, just adding insult to injury. And that goal is going to be number 19, Edenilson Dos Reis. His first goal of the day. And Bristol is putting a whooping, not like your whoopee cushion, but a whooping, our old-fashioned whooping, on the boys from the Bronx. Oh, nice nifty kick there. Sometimes you just have to admire the skill and the athleticism. Ooh, and the goalie from Monroe came out to get that one. On the last two goals, the Bradley Teixeira goal and the Dos Reis goal, the goalie made the initial save. But Bradley Teixeira and Dos Reis, Edenilson Dos Reis, they stood with it. They stood with it, got the ball back from the goalie, and put the ball in the net. And you have to admire that.
Stop
They are getting a lot of shots on goal here today. I mean, it's just been, they've been peppering this poor man. Roughly a minute left. What a jolly good day. That's a jolly good day for the Bayhawks. Again, rolling on the river today. You are watching your Bayhawks Broadcasting Network. September and October is full of soccer. The Bristol Community College women's team, 2-1, under new head coach Jason Tassinari, the Tasmanian Devil. Here's Gill with another goal! His second goal on the day. It has been a dastardly bloody day. Any way you want to put it. They put the dagger in it a long time ago, but they just keep putting daggers and putting daggers and putting daggers in that casket. For God's sakes, make it stop. Monroe saying, make it stop right now. We're already dead. You can't make us even more dead. And the time winds down. The gun goes off. The whistle goes off. And that is it here from Britland Park. We admire both teams for all their hard work out here today. Their blood, sweat, and their tears. They left it all on the table here today. Have a safe trip back to the Bronx in New York. The final score here today, the Bristol Community College men's team with a 7-0 victory here today at Britland Park. I am David Cardoza. So long, everybody, here from the park. Good night, everybody.